Good evening, everyone. I'm Dr. Satish Mohanty from Amrita Institute of Medical Science. And the study which I'd like to discuss today is entitled Prenatal Diagnosis of a Redundant Foramen Ovale Flap Aneurysm Prolapsing into the Mitral Valve, a Mimicker of Aortic Coarctation. So the primary aim of this study was to demonstrate the clinical course of a prenatally suspected coarctation and how it's related to a redundant foramen ovale flap aneurysm. So this is a case which came to us earlier last month. It was a 28-year-old woman who was referred to us from another center for a suspicion of a hypoplastic left ventricle. And we took this lady for a fetal echo. And this is what we got. So what we can see here is a four-chamber view. And as we can see here, that we have an atrial septum which has become aneurysmal and is actually moved on into the LA. It is also encroaching upon the mitral valve. In the color view, we can actually see the flows across the mitral valve into the LV are minuscule in comparison to the flows across the tricuspid valve into the RV. So we can clearly see a ventricular disproportion in both these images, in the 2D as well as the color image. And here we can see a redundant PFO flap which is bulging into the mitral valve. So this again is a four-chamber view where we have tried to compare the mitral valve annulus as well as the tricuspid valve annulus. And as you can see, the tricuspid valve annulus z-scores are minus 0.23, whereas the mitral valve is even smaller with a z-scores of minus 1.66. In the two pictures at the bottom of the screen, we have basically tried to compare the RV internal diameter as well as the LV internal diameter. As you can see, that the RV internal diameter had a z-scores of minus 0.7. Whereas the LV internal diameter is even smaller with a z-score of minus 1.7. We also took a look at the systemic and the pulmonary venous drainage which were normal. In the first image, we can actually see a bicapital view, and in the second image, we can see an intact IVC. The pulmonary venous drainage, we can see two pulmonary veins which are draining into the LA. Next, we have a three-vessel view. In this three-vessel view, we can take a look at the pulmonary artery, the ascending aorta, as well as the SVC. What we see here is the MPA measures 0.91 with a z-score of 0.63, which is normal. However, when we take a look at the ascending aorta annulus, we have a z-score of minus 1.9. Another clue in this image is the size of the SVC. So every time we see a SVC and the adjacent aorta, if the SVC and aorta sizes are equal, or if the SVC happens to be more than aorta, they are actually hints that their child might be having a smallish ascending aorta or at risk of a coarct. Now next we are taking a look at a 3VT view where we can see the isthmus diameter is 0.2 centimeters with a z-score of minus 5. Also we can see here that there is significant flow reversal in the aorta, again implying the possibility of a coarct. When we see the aortic arch here, we can see that a narrow isthmus. So the fetal echo diagnosis, what we formulated was a hypoplastic arch with isthmus, significant ventricular disproportion with great artery disproportion, and a redundant PFO which was bulging into the LV inflow. So 2 weeks later, this child was delivered here. The delivery was by LSCS in view of a previous LSCS. This child happened to be a small for gestational age child with a birth weight of 2.2 kgs. He cried immediately at birth and did not require any active resuscitation. So on the first day itself, he was taken up for a postnatal echo. Let us see what the postnatal echo showed. So this is an apical four-chamber view where we can see how the septum is still papulous, and it is only difference is it is moving on towards the RA. When we had seen the fetal echo, there the septum which was aneurysmal was actually encroaching into the mitral valve. Here we can also see the subcostal short axis view, which is again showing us the same papulous foramen ovale which is bulging into the right atrium. So let us take a look at the arch dimensions. This is the ascending aorta, which was 6.4 millimeters. We have a transverse arch which was 4.4 millimeters with a z-score of minus 2.83, and we have an isthmus with a z-score of minus 2.75, which are smallish as seen on day one of life. On the same day, this is a echo which has been done on the day three of life, where we actually saw that the mitral valve as the tricuspid valve annulus Z-scores. Here, as we can see, that the tricuspid valve Z-scores is -0.84 and the mitral valve Z-score is -0.5, which is normal. We also can right now see that the sinus as well as the sinotubular junction, the Z-scores mentions for the aortic sinus is -0.02 and that for STJ is -1.14, again which falls into the normal range. Now this is again an apical four-chamber view which has been taken on day 3, where we can see that there is still mild ventricular disproportion even though the ventricular function appears normal. Also we can see that the LV is the apex forming chamber here. Coming to the arch, which was our major point of concern, and antenatally we had actually felt that this patient is actually at a high possibility of getting a coarc later on. So here we can see that the arch is well open and the flows through it are laminar. So the diagnosis which we formulated postnatally was an aneurysmal atrial septum, mild ventricular disproportion, LV being apex forming, normal biventricular function, left arch with no coarctation. So presently the child has been discharged and is scheduled for a 1 month follow-up at our center. So conclusion or learning points from this case would be, presence of a redundant foramen valve flap aneurysm can actually mimic the coarctation of aorta. We all do understand that the possibility is when a redundant foramen valve flap encroaches upon to the mitral valve, it is actually impeding the flow into the left ventricle, which is going into the aorta. So because there is less blood flow, there is going to be less growth of the left-sided structures. And that's the reason why the left heart structures actually would be growing lesser during the fetal period. So sequential postnatal echoes need to be done postnatally. The reason being, we all do understand that when coarctation is one of those entities which actually need to be addressed surgically more so, and that too immediately. However, when it is going to be associated with a foramen ovale flap aneurysm, there is a possibility that there might be just a benign course and the child may be never phased to go for a surgery. So to keep in mind, a foramen ovale flap aneurysm is more or less a benign finding and is something which we should look for in those patients with coarct. So these are my references. Thank you.